I just caught this little bad boy. So not much, but again, it's all about, you know, finding what you can and improvising and getting a meal out of whatever the hell you can. That's the only way we're making it out of here.
Julio's refusal to eat protein to improve his physical and mental state had plunged him deeper into depression.
It's so hard to control your emotions. What the hell am I doing here? I don't belong here.
How you feeling?
I'm feeling feelings.
Like what?
I don't know. Confusion.
Confusion?
I don't know.
My mind is starting to like bring up this really dark side that I really didn't know it was that dark. And it's really scary. I'm scared of myself.
That's how it has to go. You just gotta keep, you know, keep trying to find what you can.
This place is messing me up. And just having these horrible visions and these horrible thoughts.
It's survival. I mean, that's all there is to it. And you have to eat to survive. Okay.
What? Yeah, just trying to get this clean a little bit.
I'm like sniffling a lot.
I got the sniffles. No, I'm good.
Is there anything you want to talk about?
Not really.
Well, you kind of hesitated, so are you sure?
Yeah.
Everything that he does affects me. If he's going to continue to push himself away from me, I need this to improve. I really need to talk to you. Can you and I talk?
Yeah.
And know that you're not in a good place right now. Like, I can just, you know, I can feel it. And it worries me because you're all I have out here, you know, and you're my partner, and we have to make it through this together, you know. And I can't force you to eat. I can't force you to open up. I mean, that's completely your decision, but I'm getting worried. I need to know what's going on. Like, you gotta talk to me.
I'm surprised, like, how rapidly I deteriorated in just 5 days. I'm just having, like, doubts of, like, who I am as a person. It's a really confusing feeling. It's like these really bad thoughts come to me of me doing really bad things to people and to myself.
Well, I mean, we've all got our skeletons, but hurting other people and hurting yourself, that's...
It's really scaring me.
And that's the worst possible thing that could have come out of his mouth. He wants to hurt people and himself. He can't be here. And I'm not safe with him.
Having succumbed to the extreme stress of the challenge, Julio reached his breaking point. On day 5, for his safety and for Tony's, the producers decided to take him out.
I feel really guilty that I left Tony down. And, you know, she was really polite about it, but I could tell in her eyes the disappointment and even anger, and I don't blame her. If she truly knew what was going on in my head, she would be like, yes, you need to leave.
This would be probably, I don't know, the 7th or 8th time someone's abandoned me. I mean, it's a normal gesture in my life. So as far as being here, I mean, I grew up on my own. So I can be here on my own. I'm just pissed at him. I mean, my life was destroyed by people like him. So. You have to take me out of here on a gurney. I ain't going anywhere. am alone, and there's a bear
stalking me.
I don't have advanced weapons to take down a bear. I don't know where that thing is, but if he picks up my scent, I'm screwed.
There is a fucking bear outside my shelter. I'm trying not to fucking fall apart right now. I'm so defenseless right now.
I set my entire shelter on fire. I have no words right now.